into the Venus Circle, and the highest, and her highest monthly commission check is over $10,000. Welcome, a member of the Carol Anton Nashville area, independent senior sales director, Tiffany Stout.
Well, what I want to impact and a legacy on your family forever. Is there anybody else here who likes lists? Do you like lists, like writing out lists? Okay, I do. So I thought this would be fun. Here was my top 10, like David Letterman. My top 10 is some questions that I can ask the daughter of a national sales director, and my responses. Number 10, did you always know that you wanted to be Mary Kay? And my answer to that is no. As a matter of fact, I really didn't want to be Mary Kay. I don't know if anybody else ever thought that. Anybody else think I would never do that? That was my story. And I dearly trust in that you do not want to do what my mom did, especially at age 18. And so I'm just trying to give you a little bit of hope, I think. Once I had a real job, I quickly realized why my whole family did Mary Kay. Number 9, did your mom always talk to you about doing Mary Kay? And no way. No way. If she had, I never would have done it. But I really encourage you to provide the dollars to decide for themselves. Now, her friends were a different story, and I kind of thought if I started, then maybe they would leave me alone. And it worked. Number 8, is there a lot of pressure to succeed? Well, I don't choose to perceive it that way, but I do choose to succeed anyway. I think it's great that people are cheering me on and want me to succeed. Wouldn't you just imagine getting emails and cards from people like Lisa Madison and Debbie Moore, Sandy Miller, Jean McCoy, Sam Harris? Success is a personal choice, not a curse. Number 7, can I have your autograph? Can I have a picture with you? This would be before I was in Mary Kay, and when I was a brand consultant, I was like, really? What have I done? Like, why do you want my autograph? So, I don't know, maybe people will want my picture now. Is that me? Number 6, when will you be a national? Well, I'm working on it. We're working on it, right? Oh my God, that was the real answer to that one. Number 5, can I rub up against you like some magic power is going to rub off on them? And I'm not even going to go there because that's weird. So, Number 4, what's it like having people and fun as your mom? I don't know. What's it like having your mom as your mom? This is my mom. Number 3, those are big shoes to fill. Is there a question? Actually, she wears 9.5 and I wear 7.5. And so, yeah, they are big for me, which is such a bummer because she's got really big shoes. Number 2, is your mom like a normal person? Are you laughing? Actually, she is, if you know her, she wears skin, but that just depends on what your definition of normal is. Are you going to break any of your mom's records? And my response to that was fun. I already have. There are definitely some perks, like when we draw names for Christmas Thanksgiving. There's a big family choice to draw names. You want them to get your name. Pop up a photo with my mom to a wardrobe seminar and stealing all their new products early to take them in early. Also, coming to conferences like this, it's like a family reunion and we get to write on all of our holiday get-togethers and birthday parties and stuff. You know, one great story that I loved on the first time I met Mary Kay Ash was, yes, I got to meet her, was when I was 6 months old. She came to the Bay Area. Right? I remember it clearly, like I'm young. My mom went to pick her up at the airport, and she had a beautiful suit with this gorgeous fur collar, and here's her son's baby, and she said, oh my gosh, she's so cute, can I hold her? And I said, yes, of course, absolutely, right here, you go. And then I just sit up all over her person. Lovely, right? So now, does anybody here have teenage daughters? Okay, well, you'll love this story. This is the next time I remember meeting Mary Kay. It was at my mom's National Thank You seminar when I was 14. We were on the pit at the side of the stage, about to go up, and Mary Kay turned to me, and I was looking down at her. I'm not that tall, but I was looking down at her, and she said, I'm so proud of your mom. And I was like, yes. And what I was really thinking was, what up, I can totally be back at the hotel, so we're getting a tan right now. And I'm like, really? Okay, so I'm giving hope. This is my first time being in charge. I have a lot of making up to do. My decision to start my Mary Kay business was 9 years ago. After getting my bachelor's in business marketing and a few years in the corporate world, and I quickly realized that I was never going to have the kind of lifestyle that I grew up with if I was working for someone else. At the time, I lived in San Francisco and worked there about 60 to 70 hours a week and started for some extra money, teaching me that when I was there. And to give you hope, I gave a consultant number for the first 4 years of my business. But I could go to every event, even drive 2 hours business for my weekly meetings. When I got serious about my business, I decided to actually listen to all the training that I received from my mom and my family, because I knew she was where I wanted to be one day. I wanted to have children and be able to raise them like she was with my sister and I. I wanted to be on the field trips with my kids, driving all their friends in my sweet pink Cadillac like she did. I wanted to work from home and have a flexible schedule and work out in the middle of the day if I felt like it, like I watched her do. Did she ever miss out on any of my gymnastics classes or swimming or softball games growing up? I'm sure she might have, but do I remember it? No. What I remember is learning to write my tick list and park list every night in second grade, even if it only was brush my teeth, make my bed, get on the bus. I remember the frequent family vacations to Disneyland, Europe, Hawaii, and I remember choosing any college that I wanted to go to without any college loans when I graduated or student loans. And growing up with a great relationship with my dad, also, because he got so involved in my life. Then I met my husband Seth 8 years ago, and it's an indie family. Not only did he marry me, but he married my family, my big family, Mary Kay family. More than I could ask for. He lets me sleep in, he makes me coffee in the morning and dinner at night, does our grocery shopping and laundry, and he's even learning how to blow dry our daughter's hair. I know that you're thinking, where did you find him and does he have a brother? But that was nothing. I met two more kids. We have two gorgeous girls. They're 3 and 2. Wow. And so I know that you know they keep us very busy. They're the love of our lives. I always use them as my reason to work for my business, never my excuse of why I can't, and Seth supports that. I want you to know that you can do this too. You guys can do this too. If you are single, married, have small kids, grown kids, or no kids, Mary Kay is like a blanket, and it fits your curve just the way you need it to. You get to choose how to work it. So I can share some things that I learned about growing up in my Mary Kay home and what I'm excited about passing on to my kids. And some of you may have grown up this way, and your Mary Kay kids too, or you're creating this for your families and how blessed they will be. What we always hear is that it's not about what's taught, it's what's taught. So what is your family catching? Here are my top 10 things that I taught. Number 10, think big, think huge. I don't even realize that I do it. This is part of my DNA. Until I'm around people outside of the pink bubble who just don't get it, and I never engage in their thinking if it's smaller than mine. Number 9, always have people who believe in you and learn how to believe in others. James Allen said, the outer conditions of a person's life will always be found to reflect their inner beliefs. Number 8, Mary Kay has a vision. Our nationals have a vision. Your director has a vision. Proverbs 29:18 tells us that without vision, the people will perish. Have a vision for where you are going and a plan to get there. Number 7, I was raised with the principles of God first, family second, career third, and the golden rule, and we live it. Number 6, learn that first you control the habit, then the habit controls you. The habits we create will determine our destiny. Number 5, failure does not mean that you are a failure. It just means that you're in the process of learning how to be a success. If no possibility of failure exists, then victory is meaningless. Number 4, setting goals is crucial. If you don't have a goal, you will hit it every time. That's a scary thought. Obstacles are what you see when you take your eye off of the goal. Number 3, there's a difference between being competitive and being comparative. Healthy competition and always trying to be our own best is productive, while comparing ourselves to others is destructive. We will always compare our weaknesses to others' strengths, so swim in your own lane. Number 2, when you think about bring it out, I used to make fun of my mom for saying this to me every single day of my life, until I finally saw it manifest in my own. What we think and what we tell ourselves up here is so powerful. Number 1, attitude isn't everything. It's the only thing. You know what the great thing about this is? Yes, my mom's a national, but Mary Kay calls each and every one of us her daughter. We are all daughters of the national sales directors. They're so lovely, aren't they? Gorgeous. And they're all carrying on Mary Kay's legacy with the example for us to follow so that we can pass it on too. National sales director Sandy Lewis said at leadership conference, the two most important days in your life are the day you were born and the day you know why. My prayer is that you will know why this weekend. I wanted to close with the story of the pencil maker. The pencil maker There are 5 things you need to know, he told the pencil before I send you out into the world. Always remember them and never forget, and you will become the best pencil you can be. 1, you will be able to do many great things, but only if you allow yourself to be held in someone's hands. 2, you will experience a painful sharpness from time to time, but you'll need it to become a better pencil. 3, you will be able to correct any mistakes you might make. 4, the most important part of you will always be what's inside. And 5, on every surface you are used on, you must leave your mark. No matter what the condition, you must continue to write. The pencil understood and promised to remember and went into the box with a purpose in its heart. I know you figured out that you are the pencil. You were created with a purpose. You were created with greatness inside of you. You are significant. Have a great career conference.